Sorry for that. Hello and welcome to the Celeste Modded Awards. I'm Toho and I'll be your host for this eventful evening. Thank you, Nyan, for making most of the flat environments showcased in that beautiful intro. It's truly staggering how far we've come over the years, and I'm so excited to celebrate 2023 with you all today. Sorry about the bit of buffering you experienced in the intro. Hopefully that's not gonna continue. I mean, it didn't continue in any of my tests, so we'll have to keep going, and I think my internet's picked up back again, so we should be good. I will not be doing most of the talking, however, for we have a unique announcer for every single award being presented tonight. Throughout the program, we will also have 5 trailers for upcoming maps with interviews, as well as 10 more extra trailers at the very end of the awards, kind of like a mini-direct. Additionally, there will be a task showcase and 4 special community awards interspersed throughout the program. To refresh your memory, here are the main 18 awards. If you don't quite understand what some of these mean, just stick around for each award and the announcer will give a detailed explanation. Soundtrack of the Year, Custom Deco of the Year, Clip of the Year, The Starter Award, Gimmick of the Year, The Vanilla Award, Skin Mod of the Year, The Trollshiro Award, The Incline Award, Brain Teaser of the Year, Collab Entry of the Year, Contest Entry of the Year, Collaborative Project of the Year, Art Direction of the Year, Debut Modder of the Year, The Formidable Award, Modder of the Year, and finally, Campaign of the Year. If you haven't picked up on it already, this award show is probably going to be pretty long. I estimate around 3 hours. However, there will be a 5-minute intermission in the middle where you can just grab a drink, go to the restroom, or just chillax. But for now, let's jump into it. Here we have the incredible lobby made by Nyan with assets from Nerford and Spooky, who made the banger 3D model we saw earlier. Without Nyan helping out on all fronts, and Pookie Lou doing an insane amount of video editing, the awards would just not exist. There will be more detailed credits at the end of the program, but without further ado, the first award will be Soundtrack of the Year, presented by the multi-talented Ricky06. All right.
Hey, y'all. I'm Ricky06, and I'll be briefly taking over for this portion of the Celeste Modding Awards to introduce to you the nominations for Soundtrack of the Year. So needless to say, I think a crucial part of our experience when we play Celeste mods is from its soundtrack. A well-placed song can heighten our emotions, elevate moments to make them more memorable, and, you know, immerse us into a beautiful fantasy world. Personally, I've always viewed Celeste modding as kind of a form of art, and I think part of what makes art connect with so many people is the emotion the artist imbues within their work. So from heart-pounding adrenaline-inducing gameplay to beautiful, profound scenery that can't even be described through words, I think it's safe to say that these moments that stand out in our mind wouldn't be the same if it weren't for our talented musicians. So, with that being said, I'd like to take this time to show some appreciation to everyone in the Celeste community that has helped create incredible soundtracks that enrich our modding experiences and make it so much more meaningful. Thank you all so much. Here are the nominees. And the winner of the Soundtrack of the Year award is... the Strawberry Jam OST. Congratulations.
Caterpillar could not be here tonight, so in their stead, they have given me a speech to give out, and here it is. Hey everyone, I've been out of Celeste stuff for a while now, but I'm super glad to be back for this special moment and to celebrate everyone's hard work. Congratulations to all of you for bringing this community to where it stands now, for all these amazing years of Celeste, and equally importantly, for your kindness. I'm so happy to have met so many lovely people whom I'll always respect and look up to. There's not much else I have to say for myself, except that I'm so thankful and proud to be part of this community which I've allowed to call myself home, or which I've allowed myself to call home ever since I started modding the game. Thanks to the musicians from Strawberry Jam who gave me the strength to hold and carry on. I wouldn't have picked music back up at all had I not met this little, big group of brilliant musicians. So huge thanks to you all. Special shout out to Alistitious, Matt, and Beanjamin. All right. Thank you so much. By the way, just so you all aren't confused later, paint will not be included in any words as requested by Mosscairn. Nothing wrong with this, just making sure we're on the same page. Without further ado, let me hand the stage over to Aurora Aquir, who will be presenting Custom Deco of the Year.
Hello everyone. As we all know, Celeste is an incredibly pretty game, even though it is quite limited in what it actually displays. But this results in one great advantage. It gives it an added modding. If it's easy to pick up pixel art style and it's limited resolution, you can go wild with custom decals and style grunts. While not quite trivial, Celeste graphics lets even beginners have a good shot at creating some decent decals. If you can imagine it, you can figure out a way to represent it. I'm sure of it. Want a city? Sure. Want a frozen landscape with towering mountains? We gotcha. Want a sandy beach with a tropical atmosphere? You can't go wrong with some palm trees. Custom decals truly let you represent anything you can imagine, as long as you can condense it down to a few pixels. And I believe you can. Now you have a chance to shape the environment exactly to your vision, departing from the common vanilla tones and making something uniquely beautiful. And even if you truly can't draw, others can, and many shadow decals in the asset drive. So go hand with some decals, shape your wall, and appreciate the artists that have gotten us all to this point. Here are the nominees in the category Custom Deco of the Year. And the winner of the Custom Deco of the Year award is... Garden of Kutara by Dan TKO. I'm not sure if I pronounced it right, but that's a fantastic map. Congratulations.
One second, they should be joining now.
You could talk, Dan.
Oh boy, I don't know. Well, I don't know where to start. Maybe saying thanks for nominating me, I guess. It's a shame that paint wasn't in this program at all, because honestly... If paint was in this program, it would have swept far beyond me. But honestly, I'd like to thank the Strawberry Jam team, because I mean, without that collab as a whole, it would not really be a thing, you know, because my work ethic outside of collabs has been rather dog. But besides that, just a lot of people that have helped me throughout the development of the map, and I just like to thank them as a whole, and I'd like to see more with what the community has to offer, and hopefully my map kind of, you know, inspires that in a way, even though I do kind of agree the map is rather unreadable, but it's a thing you're willing to make. But and thank you for the awards, and have a great rest of your afternoon. Thank you.
All right, thank you so much, Dan. And I want to thank everybody for putting up with some of the technical issues. I think we've got it all sorted out. I've adjusted the bitrate. But yeah, thanks so much again to Dan. Garden of Qatar is, you know, one of the most legendary and beautiful maps I've ever seen, so congrats. Hello, I'm about to present the first community award. None of these, except the last one, will be annual awards like Modder of the Year or Campaign of the Year. They will instead be custom-tailored awards for specific members or groups in the community that deserve recognition. Also, there won't really be any speeches from the winners for these. I'll simply talk in depth about how the recipients have shaped the community, the Celeste community, for the better. The first community award is the Technical Achievement Award, given to those who have pushed the boundaries of what is possible in Celeste and allowed the game to thrive in a new light. I would like to give this award to the Evers team behind Core. For those who are unfamiliar with the inner workings of Celeste, many coders have been hard at work over the past year and change, working on shifting Celeste from a .NET framework with a 4GB memory limit to a Core framework that can make full use of all the memory on your system. The main architect behind this project was Popax21, who worked tirelessly in order to revitalize the game and make it accessible to players on clunkier computers. Loading times halved for many, and performance was improved across the board. Personally, as you can tell, I'm hosting this awards show off of a beat-up 2020 MacBook, and it was borderline impossible to play SJ when it first came out. However, Core literally saved the collab for me, making it run basically like any other computer at a smooth 60 frames per second. Essentially rewriting the game from the ground up, being bombarded with bug reports on the daily, this is not a simple undertaking. However, the Evers team still managed to face all this with grace, unlocking the true potential of Celeste and its difficult platforming for a great number of new players. I'd be remiss to talk about the Evers team and not mention Maddie480, who is genuinely one of the kindest, most generous souls, not only in the Celeste community, but in any gaming community. By constantly answering questions, debugging other modders' technical issues, and adding features, she has helped hundreds, if not over 1,000 modders throughout her time in the Celeste community. She consistently, nay, religiously, chooses to take time out of her day to assist anyone experiencing logistical troubles. I think this community is truly blessed to have coders like Maddie, Popax, and others on the Evers team. They are the very backbone of Celeste modding and create a seamless experience that we as players can sometimes take for granted. With that in mind, it is my honor to bestow the Technical Achievement Award to the Evers team. I'm not sure who this is since the forms are anonymous, but someone from the Evers team typed in the nominees form. This may be on the edge of the scope of this question, but I want to share how cool of a year it has been for the backbones of Celeste modding. It has been a super enjoyable year contributing, helping, and providing feedback to this volunteer organization that is often forgotten about. One of my favorite experiences has been testing the Core update, following its development, and seeing how this game is still active, just like if it was released a couple of months ago. So it is my turn to say thank you to all of the volunteers passionate for this little project that we have been developing and improving this amazing, silly tool called Everest. Thanks again, and absolute legends. Well deserved. Next up, we have Viddy presenting the Clip of the Year award, and this one's going to work a bit differently, but I'll let him explain it. All right, take it away.
I hope you can hear me. Hey guys, I'm Viddy. If you know me, I love Celeste, and I love Goldens, and I especially love streaming those, because Goldens can be a wild ride. One day, you're breezing through hard gameplay you've just learned, and another day, you just keep dying to the same stupid, arguably not even hard inputs. But ultimately, doing that one run that goes from start to finish is always amazing, and streaming takes all of this and makes it even better. Having a bad session? At least I can talk to chat about stuff. Getting a new personal achievement? All the more hype and much sweeter when a bunch of people are witnessing it live with you. I love looking back at old videos of stuff that I've done and seeing chat go crazy. It's just so awesome. But even having chat there when funny or silly things happen or just to casually talk to is also just awesome. If this was actually the reason why I started streaming in the first place, like, initially, I just wanted to document my 70 golden progress, but everything I talked about just now is the reason why I actually continued streaming after I achieved my goal. And I'm sure that other people definitely share these feelings about streaming too. And so, yeah, let's see what we have, what happened last year in terms of funny clips. So I'm going to present this year's nominees for the extra big category of Clip of the Year.
I wanna die. Shout out to the ad that's playing right now.
There's no ad playing now. There's 4 more minutes and I did it. Yay.
Oh, so someone got an ad then.
What? That's not possible. Okay.
I don't know.
Where can I pet cats? I need to know where to pet cats. Why is there spinners on that roof?
What do you mean there's a feather? What do you mean? Oh my fucking god! You can't be serious! Why is there a feather? What the fuck has a feather to do there? Oh my.
What is this doing here?
I don't even think I need it, but... There's a no.
Ah. Ah! Fucking. Ah, you bastard! I fell for it again!
Okay, but what if I, like, don't? Biggest mistake of my life, bro! Holy. No, I didn't mean it! No! Go! Ah!
Oh, I love. When did you have the little meme so close?
Ah, I know how to.
Oh, yeah.
Please don't tell me you're. I'm gonna. Oh, you're so nice.
I love you, Ricky. I love you.
We love that troll.
I am so dumb.
You know what, I worked out. It's fine.
Shut up.
Shut up.
Stop! Not the knife in the form! Consistency tracker for the baking of this steak. How else am I supposed to spread it?
Blangu says, chat, remember, this is a once-in-a-lifetime stream cast.
Just use oil. Well, that's too late.
Okay, we're so chilling, actually. Fuck you. Fuck.
What the huh?
No. Dude.
The name of the room is Gay.
Excuse me? What kind of lunar cycle jank was that, right?
Reminds me. The worst debug room in history. Where's the pixel?
What? What do you mean?
Have some confidence. No cap, we be bussing straight up this stream. I assume the typos are intended. Dog rolls. I'll just assume the typos are intended to add to the effect. Have some confidence. I'm sorry, I'm just not a huge slang user. You know, I'm just not always hip and jive with the modern slang. I'll try to be more jiggy with it in the future, you know?
In this video, I'm going to be splipping strangers' droosts. But first, Cassested Fooper all over that subscribe button, or you will get mind blocked.
That's insane. That's genuinely crazy. I...
Bro, I'm so fucking stupid!
Hey, Care, you see the gap in the spikes down there? Dropsel reference? Oh. It is a
Dropsel
reference.
Do you have any advice to our watchers to be more shrimpy?
Young shrimps out there looking to become a big king shrimp, I recommend never eating shrimp. Go vegan.
How GM? Super expert. No! No, you motherfuckers! This is you!
Oh my god, Iris was streaming?
Oh my gosh.
That's what I mean. Manga wild, Misei child, super starry, super style. Passion in my pants, I'm making a scene. Shatter my song, got a luminous bong. I'm a fractured cave with my B-sized dong. Though I honest, pins on my balls took my soul or my number. woosting and moosting and coosting and troosting till I can choose thing. Wouncing and mouncing, I'm flouncing. Back to coosifer announcing. Bitches pour like seven.
Oh my god! Yes! Wait, I did it! 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 I fucking did it! I fucking did it! I fucking did it! Guys, I fucking did it! I fucking did it! I fucking did it!
Fuck it up. Yeah, that's good.
I'm shaking so hard.
Dude. Oh my god. Holy shit. Holy shit. That's holy shit. No way. What? What?
That's it.
What the fuck? What the fuck?
Oh my god. Holy shit. No way. What? Oh my god. Holy shit. What? What? What?
Let's fucking go.
He still has an undeath him.
Oh my god.
Yeah. No fucking way.
What the fuck?
What?
What?
Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh my god. Please. Oh my god. Yes! Yes! Yes!
I guess you could say farewell.
And the winner of the Clip of the Year award is SJ Rep from Parrot Dash. Congratulations.
Parrot's streaming, so I'll imagine it'll take him a hot minute to join, but I'm sure he will eventually.
Oh.
GG.
Well, that was unexpected. I did not expect this clip to be featured. Okay, I have a lot of sound. I have my own stream and the stream and the screen share. I'm sorry. Thanks to whoever nominated the clip. Shout out to Yannick. I told him on stream, would you sing this? Would you rap this for $10? And it was like, sure. And it was the most worthy $10 I've ever spent. That was awesome. Thank you. I don't have that much more to say. But I appreciate it.
Alright, thank you so much to Parrot Dash. And with that, we have a special event. We have the first trailer. So strap in and get ready for a world premiere. And many of y'all have been anticipating this, so get ready. All right, welcome Nine to the stage.
I can't hear Toho if he's talking to me.
You can hear me now, probably.
I can hear you now, probably.
Okay, cool. That's so probably core.
Yes.
How's it going?
It's going. Is it hot in here, or is it just me?
It's hot for me in here, like, it's scalding, but...
It's scalding, but... We
for now,
going.
Let's talk about your banger heater of a contest, yes. Music Very Translation excited. Contest 2. For those who are not aware, can you explain what the basic concept of it is?
I'd love to. So everyone has songs they want to use in maps, but the maps maybe just don't fit the song quite right. Well, now is the perfect excuse to use that song in a map. The main goal of the contest is to have a song that you love and put it, just like close your eyes and like imagine it as a Celeste map and then make it. We're gonna have 3 weeks to do it this time around, a little more than last time, and there's a lot of actually really fun things we managed to figure out this time around. I say we as in me and Toho because we're judging, but I'm the main host. We're gonna be using Game Banana Jams this time, which is the first contest to do that, and I've yet to unpublic or unprivate the pages for that because I am in the middle of award stuff. But as soon as the awards is over, I will post some stuff in Modding Showcase and Celeste Chord. And we will start mapping. I'm really excited to see what everyone does.
All right. Do you think this contest is going to be a regular annual event, or?
I can't say that for sure. It depends on demand of people. I know people were really looking forward to doing this, and I kept delaying it until I had free time, and now I have some free time. So, you know, if people want me to keep doing this every year, I'll do it every year. I love music as much as the next guy.
Do you think there'll be another mini award ceremony like last year?
100%. Even if we don't get as big as a turnout as this year, if we get like 9 people, I'll hype up those 9 people. Like, I am your biggest fan.
Let's go. Love to hear it. Anything else you want to say?
If you're a Nyan fan like myself, this will not be the last time I'm talking during the awards. I am doing a nomination and a few other exciting things down the line. So just stay hype, Nyan fans, because I know there's so many of you.
All right, we get it, we get it. Get off the stage.
All right.
All right, we're heading back to our regularly scheduled awards with the Starter Award being announced by Donker19.
Hey everybody, I'm Donker19. You may know me from the classic Madeline Plays Fall Guys or Jash of Solaris special. I'm here to discuss what I think makes a starter map truly special. Accessible maps. Who doesn't love a chill beginner slash intermediate map to play after a long week? I think part of what makes these easier maps so special is that they cannot rely on complicated setups, advanced tech, or chain ultras to get people interested. These starter mods must have character ingrained into them to be as alluring as some of the harder maps. I'm no stranger to making accessible maps, and I believe there's one key component to making a good beginner map turn into a special experience, and that's character. I like to take this opportunity to mention what factors I believe can give these maps character and make those beginner maps truly special. The first thing, and likely most obvious, is decoration. When I map, not having any sort of decoration down can really make me hate what I'm working on. I mean, come on, staring at cliffside alt or cement in front of a black background, maybe with some mist doesn't really motivate me to keep working, let alone motivate you to keep playing. This year, some of the prettiest mods ever have been released. And maps that have great deco and good gameplay are just so fun to experience, because while you're savoring that great gameplay, you're also constantly looking at the map. Imagine that one scene from Ratatouille where Remy combines two different flavors at once. Oh yeah, that's peak, baby. Deco can really create an atmosphere for a map, so it's easy to see why that's important. Another huge thing that can elevate mods, especially starter mods, is narrative, and intertwined with that, secrets. When I was first playing through Farewell, my primary motivator to beat it was to see the conclusion of the story. Having even just a little narrative can really help you make your mod stand out. However, I was enticed to go back a second time by the secret Moonberry, spoiler alert, sorry. However one wants to express their narrative and secrets is up to them. Whether it may be through cute dialogue, hints of a deeper secret, optional lore tablets, or even an alternate ending if you do X. Narrative and secrets can really elevate an easier map for me and turn it into something I'll remember for a very long time. However, you want to make your map special, go for it. These are merely my opinion, of course, but nothing will change the fact that I think more accessible and easier mods are the best way to relax while playing this incredible game. Thank you so much for this incredible opportunity, Toho, and I hope you enjoy the award show. Now, without further ado, the nominees for the starter award are And the winner of the Starter Award is The Summer Before Christmas by Ricky 06.
Ricky, you're muted.
Alright. Hi. Yeah. I did not expect this. I actually did not write a speech for this, so I'm just gonna kind of wing this. But yeah, I'm like super flattered that I was actually given this award. I did not expect that to actually happen. I think, I mean, Summer Before Christmas was definitely like one of the most fun I've had making Celeste mods. And I think the fact that it was like a gift for Power AV as well, for their Secret Santa map, that just made it so much better. And I think probably in recent memory, it's just kind of seeing their reaction and everyone's reaction playing through that map was so fun. So that's definitely like a core memory for me. But yeah, thank you so much. I'm like super flattered. I think there's like a lot of amazing like beginner intermediate maps this year. So I'm like actually really surprised that I won this one, but I do really appreciate it. And I'm happy that everyone else loves it so much. I appreciate the support a lot, and love to, you know, give back to the community.
For sure.
I think that's it for me. Thank you.
Yeah, huge congrats to Ricky. I know that map blew, like, everybody's minds when they played it, so... Absolute legend. Next up, we got Tobia announcing Gimmick of the Year.
Hello, I'm Toby AA, Toby A, whatever. This is Gimmick of the Year for, you know, weird, crazy stuff that maps do that are not normal. Like, Celeste modding, right? It's, you know, tech. And that's That's all fine. That's all good. But it's always a blast, I think, when a mod like does something totally out of left field that you just never seen done before. Sometimes it's custom coded. Sometimes it's cobbled together with Eevee Helper. Sometimes it's just a weird combination of stuff from vanilla. But no matter what, it's always fun. It's always an amazing addition to a map to have some weird thing. It can like make you feel like you're playing a whole different game. Maybe it makes you feel like you're playing Celeste for the first time again. And maybe it's like super clever and you're like, oh, of course. And just the best gimmicks, I think, just make maps unforgettable. So here are the nominees. So the gimmick of the year is the Elytra from Communal Hopper.
Unfortunately, Caterpillar couldn't be here again, so here's a message from them. For the coders, thanks for maintaining a solid part of what we stand on, from Everest to Lawn, wink. Shout out to my fellow code modders, for whom I wish the best in the future endeavors, and big hug to my dearest Celeste friends, Viv, Luna, and Flynn. Alright, thanks so much. Immediately taking a U-turn from Gimmick of the Year, Dan TKO will be presenting the Vanilla Award, which you accidentally got a sneak peek of earlier.
Hello there. Okay, well, hello again. It's me, Dan TKO, or Daniel T-shirt KO for formalities, if you want that. I'm rambling again, but now I'm introducing the Vanilla Awards. Now, the Vanilla Awards is dedicated to those who take a step back from all of the awesome entities, utilities, and even assets that have been sprouted in the community time and time again. I mean, from the last awards, he had the Elytra, the Polyrhythm Blocks. There's a lot of things that came out of the community just this year, last year. I don't know what time it is, but with all that being said, with time and time again, and delve into the core, quote-unquote core, of what makes Celeste the game that we all know and love. Now, through this motivation, people within the community have been able to make jaw-dropping and awe-inspiring gameplay and decoration within the given limits that it just boggles my mind. People have made very complicated-looking routing gameplay with just zip movers and crystal... it's just crazy. I wish I can do it, but I'm just gonna stick to what I know best. With maps that utilize entities that were used during cutscenes, the big eye monster in 5A, and taking decoration only more tedious than applying for college. I mean, this category is truly special in the realm of originality. There's so much things you can do. It's just amazing. Besides that, this award highlights just how far this community's growth in terms of modding and creativity has come in the last 5 odd years. If you go back to 2018 and you look at most of the June collab and compare it to maps that release as standalones now, it is such a big difference. Even like the ones that entered vanilla contests, those ones sweep to June collab and other maps that released before. Some still test, you know, stand the test of time, but we're just leagues above now than we have ever been. I might bite my words later down the line, but who knows? Honestly, if limitations doesn't breed creativity, then I don't know what does. But with all that being said, here are the nominees for the Vanilla Awards. Enjoy. And the winner of the Vanilla Award is Crisis on Celeste Mountain by Quinnigan. Congratulations.
Hi, do I start talking? Wasn't expecting that, honestly. That's really cool. Fuck. I guess. Shout out Zucchini for letting me make a 131 room map for a contest. It's kind of insane for that, but I don't think it would have been made if he didn't let me do that. So, woo. This was a really fun map to make. It's just, I love making nonlinear stuff, and I'm really glad that so many people got so much enjoyment out of it, and just, like, seeing the reactions to people playing it and talking about it just felt really nice, and it was nice to see other people have fun playing it. Yeah. Free Palestine. Thank you.
based as hell. That's my goat, Quinnigan. Give it up for Quinnigan. Let's go. Next up, another trailer from a pair of little slightly silly modders.
I got like, chills watching that again. Oh my god.
That is exactly what they call me. We're doing great. Thank you.
Oh, it's been good.
It was me. And yeah, I think, hope everyone looks forward to it. It's just a little teaser for now, still in the works. But yeah, I think both me and Zucchini would agree that this is like, I think we kind of went into this map thinking it'll be our flagship map in a way. So we're putting a lot of effort into this.
We want this to be big.
Yeah, it's gonna be cool.
Nice, nice. All right, I was muted on stream, so... For the viewers, this is the Celeste Jesus of Celeste Modding and the Tumblr daddy of Celeste Modding, Ricky06. And they're doing well today, apparently. And yeah, it was an amazing trailer. So, like, how did you decide to team up?
What was it? I think, was it Bissy that brought us together? I know Bissy was Bissy and Fonda were originally part of this project.
Yeah, I think it was Bissy.
I wanted to add you, and then Bissy wanted to add Fonda. Then Bissy and Fonda kind of fell out a little bit, but they're still, like, gonna help, I think.
Yeah, yeah.
And guest roommate, too. I'm hyped.
Nice, yeah. Nice. Did you instantly know you were gonna make a move block map, or did that just come about?
The mechanic palette has actually changed a little bit. There's a custom mechanic or two that's not shown off in the trailer. You'll see those eventually.
I was gonna say, given
maybe a few,
given that your last collaboration was Boomtown, you know, that makes sense.
Yeah. I think you've specifically seen it, but there was gonna be like, if anybody's played popular maps, Witch to Vista, it has the blocks from those. Or it had the blocks from those. It doesn't anymore. Because we've actually like started this map up from the ground up twice now.
Yeah. Oh, wow. Yeah, that's
for a couple reasons.
Interesting. Wow.
Yeah.
Yeah. I feel like we've made like 75 rooms total at this point.
Honestly, it's a lot. Yeah.
I think
but,
maybe we could be a third of them. We'll see. Yeah.
We'll see. We'll see how it goes.
Are you gonna release a little, you know, Spark in the Machine scrap side or no?
Maybe we'll keep it in like the debug menu or something.
Yeah. I think keeping it in debug or just like various silly little videos that I can entertain hashtag Celeste users with.
Yeah, I'll have endless content.
Yeah.
I respect it.
Seems. Like, I made like 9 rooms yesterday.
Holy crap.
I was just sitting in VC and I saw Zucchini just mow down 9 different rooms in like 3 hours. It was insane.
Average buff green modded, goddamn.
I was going crazy with it, so.
Jesus turned empty lawn rooms into wine, and that's how he got his name. Yep. It seems like there's some pretty heavy lore. Was Ricky the main story lord like his other maps, or did you both work on it in conjunction?
Kind of both, I think.
Have anything really?
No, we got lore. We have to keep the mystique, you know.
Yeah. It's like, we want to show this off here. It's in the wings. There will be. Yeah. There will be something.
Mm-hmm. Cool. How did y'all get Soggy Milk to join the project? And for those of you who don't know, Soggy Milk dropped some bangers in Spring Collab like a while ago, but they haven't really been active since, so how'd that come about?
Right, I mean, shout out to Soggy Milk, first of all. Like, they're awesome. I love their music. Yeah.
Music brought me back to the project.
I think we got, like, Bissy new Soggy Milk, so.
That was a Bissy connection.
Yeah, Bissy's our networking connection person.
Nice. You probably can't say, but... Oh, actually, you already said. Never mind. How many rooms do you think this will be?
Ooh.
That's a good question. What do you think, Ricky? I don't know.
I have no clue.
We are on the same page here, then.
Yeah, we'll keep it a surprise. It won't be short, though. It'll be, like, a pretty sizable map.
Yeah, no, we do want this to be long.
Yeah.
Cool. All right, final question. I saw a lot of sparks, but will there ever be a spark in the machine or just, you know, out in the wild?
No, we try to keep it out of there just to avoid, like, the whole, like, fire.
That's a fire hazard. The dramatic irony. I love it.
Do we have time to ask the audience questions, or do we dip, or what do we do here?
I mean, I was going to ask you if you had anything else to say. Or...
Yeah, I got nothing else to say.
Yeah, I'm done. All right. Shout out to everyone who's been working on this project. Really fun, and I hope people look forward to it.
That sounds sick. Good to hear.
I'm excited to show more of this off in the future.
Mm-hmm. Thanks for having us.
Thanks for having your trailer in here.
Thanks for working on the awards. It's been super good so far.
Have a good evening. I'm trying to just get better and better at transitions and stuff as I go on.
For sure. It's a learning process.
I did a ton of practice. You're doing great, though. Did a ton of practice, but the real thing hits different for real. But all right, I'll see you guys later.
All right, have a nice one. Thank you for this.
You too.
All right. After that interview, I'm going to be handing the mic over to Hydro, who will be presenting Skin Mod of the Year. I think it was down. Nope, it's to the left. I'm cracked.
Is this where I talk, or? Yeah, okay, cool. I'm Hydro, and I'm going to be presenting the Skin Mod of the Year Award. So, have you ever got bored of seeing the same old Madeline sprite on screen after thousands upon thousands of hours of gameplay? Well, we have the solution for you. Introducing Skin Mods. In the Celeste community, we have a group of highly skilled artists willing to make hundreds upon hundreds of different sprites so that you can play as your favorite character. Personally, while I don't currently use any skin mods, I have done so for extended periods of time in the past, and I honestly just love that such a tiny change in the grand scheme of things can make for such a different gameplay experience. There's just something incredibly goofy and charming about seeing a slug cat pay cat aisle, or fucking Hatsune Miku playing LXVI that isn't quite achievable in any other way. Anyway, without any further ado, here are the nominations for Best Skin Mod of 2023. And the winner of the Skin Mod of the Year award is... Astolfo by Cookset and Spooky. Round of applause, please. Spooky would like deafened, I think.
Hello! Can I talk now? Is it good? This is nuts! I don't know if Cookset is here as well. I don't know if that's how you pronounce your name, but I'd like to give a huge shout out to Cookset, because I would have not have completed the skin mod without them. It's like... it was pretty tricky, because I'd never really done anything like that before, and it was so much work, and it was in the period of time where Skin Mod Helper was being sort of developed into Skin Mod Helper Plus, and I had no clue what was going on. So huge shout out to Cookset for you know, helping me get through that, and also I guess Rue for the initial request for the skin mod to be created. Everyone loves Astolfo, I guess. Skin mods are a lot of work, so and probably much more than people expect. So props to all the skin modders out there. I think pretty much every skin modder is producing some crazy good stuff. Cutie Pie, definitely. Zara's amazing Eevee mod was just like one of my favorites, definitely. Some crazy stuff behind that one. And obviously a huge shout out to AAA 1459 for continuing to develop Skin Mod Helper. And be able to, you know, make all this possible for people to make their favorite characters and for people to play with them. So this is quite a surprise to get this, but thank you very much.
Yeah, for my part, I really didn't expect to be here. I thought, of course, that Spooky would have one same award, but I want to kind of. I want to tell like kind of my story how I got into modding, because I think there are many people who want to get into modding but they don't really know how to and they are very scared. So I want to say that the Celeste community is really supportive. So if you start doing stuff, you will naturally start doing stuff with other people. So I started with my strawberry mod. And after the AAA reached out to me, asked if I could add skinning support to it, we started working together slightly with the Skin Mod Helper Plus. And from that, I gained experience with it and started to help other people like Spooky making skins, and I have become part of this wonderful community. And everyone else can too if they just make mods and interact with this community, because it is so supportive.
All right, thanks you all so much. It's legendary to see the Astolfo skin mod finally get completed and in such a beautiful, you know, poetic way. Are you curious what the Troll Shiro reward is? Find out in this upcoming feast served up by the marvelous Nyan.
Guys, I hate to break it to you, but there is an ice cream truck outside, so I have to make this really quick, all right? Okay, Troll Shiro. Okay, let's do this. Every year, brave souls attempt to walk across the fine line that is making the troll map. It takes a surprising amount of skill to create something that can feel like it's actively working against you, but still be enjoyed. It is truly a unique skill set that only people who have trained for hundreds of hours can achieve. These people are trusted to make us laugh, trusted to make us cry, and at the end of the day, they're our Troll Shiro guy. Let's see the nominees.
Thank you.
All right, and the winner of the Troll Shiro Award is Summit Downside by Linge.
Summit, I mean, Linge could unfortunately not be here today, so they have left this speech. Zephyr. Just kidding. Thank you everyone for putting up with my map. Smiley face. Alright. That's pretty much it. Thank you, Linge, for making one of the greatest getting over it likes of all time. Next up, another community award. This community award, the Frontier Award, is awarded to a group of people who truly pushed Celeste in an entirely new direction through their efforts, expanding the reach of the game to a much broader scope and inviting in hundreds of new players from across the globe to modded Celeste. This award goes to the Strawberry Jam team. What this team has been able to achieve is beyond understanding. A Herculean team effort that spanned multiple years and rough spots in order to arrive at a beautiful, one-of-a-kind final product. Remember the day that SJ released with over 100 people waiting in CelesteNet together? People got so hyped about this collab, not just because it was memed a ton or because it was the sequel to Spring Collab. People got so hyped because they recognized the latent beauty in the collab that was cultivated for years, and they could tell that the collab would fulfill and surpass their expectations like it did. So many community award submissions in the nominations form cited SJ Heartsides as their most significant Celeste experience in 2023. Quote, "My playthrough of Starfruit Supernova is genuinely one of the most incredible things I've ever experienced in any form of media." Another quote, "Flag 1 from the Grandmaster Heartside is easily one of my all-time favorite gaming experiences." So many people working on the collab took time out of working on their map in order to assist someone else and help with each other's work and help it shine the brightest it could possibly shine. Shoutouts to Big Kahuna, Bissy, Aiden, Linge, Gamation, Valkyra, all of the artists, all of the musicians, Rin, and so many more for putting in hundreds, if not thousands of hours into making Strawberry Jam Collab a truly transcendent project that defies convention. I don't really have much more to say about it. If you've played it, you know what I mean. And the amount of new mappers that have started making maps since Strawberry Jam Collab came out is absolutely outstanding, and I couldn't be more grateful. I now formally present the Frontier Award to the Strawberry Jam team. Alright, here to kick things up a notch, Noah Crawfish will be up next, presenting the Incline Award.
Hello, I'm Noah Crawfish. Advanced to Expert is where players open themselves up to experiencing all the movement possibilities in Celeste that won't give you carpal tunnel. The maps in this difficulty range are exceptionally varied in style while remaining accessible to the majority of players. Whether we wager the winner was Wave Dash Wall Bounce or you propose people prominently prefer perplexing puzzles, there's a little something for everyone. Congratulations to everyone nominated, and it's my honor to present this year's Incline Award for the best Advanced to Expert map.
We'll be right back.
And the winner of the Incline Award is... UFO Nest by Goot Vendor. Congratulations.
Alright, Goop Vendor could unfortunately not make it today, but he has left a speech. Thank you for voting for UFO Nest. I've heard rumblings in the community, rumors exchanged in hushed tones. Some are saying that the map is low-key goated and has quirked up white boy swag. Who am I to disagree? Goodbye. One of the most legendary speeches from one of the most legendary modders. Give it up for Goop Vendor. And we have a trailer, my bad. And this one's gonna be pretty epic. Alright, that was a banger trailer.
So on mute.
Alright, that was a banger trailer. Smoothie, are you here?
I'm here.
Nice.
It's an honor to be here with you, Toho. Good evening.
It's an honor to be with you here, too. Sorry, I fucked up and left my mic on. So you could hear the fans, but it's my bad. But I have to make sure that framing device is a central part of the map, right? It's not just video editing magic.
Oh yeah, I can see why that would be confusing. The black frame is in-game. It's like a style ground trick, and it's like each room will have a sort of different frame to give it a sort of identity. So it is very purposeful.
Nice. At the beginning, there was a lot of footage of 1A speedrunning gameplay. Did ILs or speedrunning in general play a factor in this map's conception?
Absolutely, yes. So the sort of concept behind the map is, you know, Celeste was designed with speedrunning in mind. And that makes it so, like, I think the most beautiful part of the movement really shines when you're going fast. And so it's natural that, you know... If I'm interested in sort of the pure movement of Celeste, what I really want to do is create a speedrunning map. And a lot of that inspiration absolutely comes from, like, IL speedrunning, especially, like, 1A. you know, when people are optimizing it super close to the task. But then also, I took a lot of inspiration from like tasks themselves, because, you know, I tried to look at tasks and think like, okay, that's the coolest thing I've ever seen. Is there any way I can make an easier version, that kind of thing? So absolutely, yeah, there's a lot of inspiration from like top level speedrunning tasks and that kind of thing.
Nice. So one of the key goals in each screen of MOV is trying to reach a key final speed that lets you clear a gap. But in this map, it looks like you're just trying to optimize speed everywhere, just every single little movement. So what lessons have you learned while making MOV that contributed to making this map so cool, or what lessons have you learned since MOV?
Yeah, I feel like, you know, for all the maps I've made, I've had like a similar mapping philosophy, which is to try and like kind of create a kind of a blank canvas for the player to like create movement themselves, and they're like they're movement artists. You know, I want to give the opportunity a canvas for self-expression through movement, and MOV, you know, is a natural way into that, inspired by stuff like a nice view. We were trying to get lots of speed, but this is like geodesic is like the natural conclusion of that philosophy, where I'm really just trying to like the kind of movement, I'm just trying to create like the weirdest like amalgamations of tech to the point that it's unrecognizable, and like taking techless movement and like pushing it to the absolute limit of its density, doing stuff like that. And so it's a similar kind of concept where in terms of that like blank canvas thing between MOV and geodesic, but like the thing that's similar between them is that it focuses in on like what you can do just with the movement system, just with Madeline. So it I think it'll have a similar experience of playing it, but obviously you're doing very different things, and this one is going to be kind of as dense of inputs as I can possibly make it, as you can kind of see.
Yeah, that's genius. So I want to talk more about the framing device. Like, was it harder or easier to design screens with that restriction than it would be without?
You know, like, for this map, I've had to think a lot about, like, constraints breeding creativity, because obviously, like, there's a lot of constraints on this map and in each individual room, because I'm trying to give each one a really strong identity, because that's something I really love in maps. But if I'm trying to give room like a really strong identity, but all I'm using is like foreground tile movement and speed running, then I have to like find other ways. This constraint of like framing the screen in a certain way, making it look like a square or whatever, I just think it looks cool. And it just makes me think about, it gives me more ideas in terms of what kind of movement might you fit in this. So like one of the screens you saw in that trailer, you know, where the screen was sort of, it was a very flat screen. It was sort of narrow horizontally. I started with that framing device. Well, really it was, I like came up with a concept for a move that I might be able to expand on, for like several seconds, and then thought like, okay, am I moving, you know, I noted that I'm moving more horizontally. Like there's not much of vertical movement that I can do while riffing on this movement idea. And so I try and confine the screen like that, and then that informs the process of actually like making the room itself and riffing on movement ideas. So it's kind of a way to help me, but it also helps to give the rooms a really strong identity.
Mm. I just want to add, this isn't really a question, but I think the door closing right before you get to it, or like if you get barely just not enough speed, that's such like a genius reimagining of like not making a gap, like falling right before you get a gap. Like, right. That's such a cool way to just disappoint the player immediately.
The idea is like, you know, with the kind of like top level speedrunning inspiration I'm taking here, like you're gonna need to be, it's not, nothing's gonna be frame perfect, because, you know, I hate stuff that's frame perfect, but like you're gonna need to be able to like saving, you need to be saving frames, like it says in the trailer. And a lot of times, like in my own, like practicing of the rooms and stuff and building them, like, yeah, you can get like frames off and feel that crushing disappointment. And I think that's so awesome.
Nice. All right. Yeah. I have three short questions remaining.
Sure.
Are you willing to share how many rooms there are or will be or not yet?
Somewhere, it's not going to be huge. It's going to be somewhere between like 5 or 10 main rooms, like you saw in the trailer, but then kind of similar to MOV, like there'll be really shorter, like 1 or 2 input rooms, which are just like cool movement ideas I wanted to give a shot in between the larger ones. But yeah, 5 to 10 big ones.
What difficulty would you say it is, roughly?
Fuck if I know. I have made more hardless maps than I've played. So, hard. Probably harder than MOV. But it depends on your skill set. Speedrunners might be good at it. So, no idea.
Makes sense. All right, lastly, what is your favorite tech?
My favorite tech? Jeez. That has to be one that has a name.
I mean, you can invent one right now.
I'll invent my favorite tech. Of course. Okay, I know the answer. My favorite tech is a climb jump.
Let's go.
I almost thought of like the tagline for this map for a while has been like a love letter to climb jumps, because I feel like climb jumps are underused in maps, especially like hard maps. So, and you know, in this map, in order to like create a room with the constraints that I'm thinking with, I have to think like, okay, what are the possible things you can do if you press like jump and then dash and then jump right after a dash? And a lot of those happen to involve, a lot of the options for those kinds of inputs involve climb jumps. So you're gonna have to spam climb jumps and stuff. I love climb jumps.
Nice. All right, thank you so much. Anything else you want to share?
No. Thank you so much, Joe. It's been a pleasure.
It. Likewise, yeah.
Have a good night.
Have a good night. In the spirit of smoothie and quirked up maps, the next award will be the Brain Teaser Award, announced by Irisu624. And by the way, this is the last award before the intermission, so hang in there and you'll get to go to the bathroom soon.
Hi, I'm Irisu. The Brain Teaser of the Year Award is here to celebrate the best puzzly maps that came out in this last year. These maps add a whole new form of challenge outside of just pure input difficulty and get the player to really think critically about how to solve the room presented to them. Sometimes this is through using existing or custom mechanics in new and creative ways, and sometimes it's through making the player logically try to figure out the exact route for an otherwise complicated and confusing room. These maps also have kind of a unique characteristic of being able to provide a similar mental challenge for players of any mechanical skill level, or for putting forth a series of demanding high-level moves that ask the most of both your brain and your hands. But either way, solving a well-put-together puzzle can be one of the most rewarding feelings that Modded Celeste has to offer. And crafting these puzzles in a way that's both creative and fun is an incredible task. These 5 nominees showcase some of the best puzzle maps that the community created in 2023. Here are the nominees for Brain Teaser of the Year. The winner of the Brain Teaser of the Year award is Labyrinth Mew by Apples.
Unfortunately, Apples could not be here tonight, but they have left a speech. Thank you all for making this community such a lively place. Modding this silly little game has been a major part of my life for pretty much the last 5 years. As a mapper, as a playtester, and a community member, it makes me so happy to see that its modding scene is now bigger and better than ever before. I love the enthusiasm and passion people put into doing and discussing everything, and I really hope to see it continue for years to come. We've only made a dent into what's currently possible, and people are creating new mechanics, breaking new ground in gameplay, visuals, and accomplishing feats I would have said were unfeasible just 2 years ago. I think nothing demonstrates this better than the fact that we can have this event right here, right now, just for the modding community of one game. Like, that's crazy. Humongous thanks to Toho and Nyan for all they've done for the community. I know this has been a big project, and it's awesome to see it finally realized. I always hate writing sappy stuff like this, but once more, from the bottom of my heart, thank you all. And thank you, Apples. That was a really, really beautiful speech, and me and Nyan appreciate it very much. And well-deserved award, by the way. Probably my third favorite map of the year last year, so huge. Alright, it is about that time for the 5-minute intermission. Feel free to get up and stretch, take care of yourself, whatever you need to do. I do recommend that you be back in time when the 5 minutes are up, because we may have a special surprise in store. So, Strawberry Jam has actually been hiding a secret map.
What do you mean?
So you've heard of life on the moon, right?
Not this again.
No, listen, it makes sense.
How? If anything, the whole prologue situation proved that Strawberry Jam hates the idea of ARGs.
Wait, listen. Beginner Lobby is the only area without a space level. Think about it. Sleeping Under Stars, Call of the Void, Expert Lobby, and the Solar Express.
Life on the moon literally has tech.
Before Busy overhauled the map.
What are you talking about?
So, there are many different variations of Busy. Purple, golden, somber, and even gray.
Oh, so it's like V.
Yeah, exactly. You can find gray Busy in some secret dialogue for potential for anything.
Wait, isn't that a beginner space map?
Well, to activate him, you have to backtrack from the only space area in the map, the heart room.
So, what does he say?
That's the thing. He doesn't say anything. Alright, welcome back. Thank you so much to Built by Gamers for sponsoring this video. Built by Gamers being Above Zucchini and Quirked Up White Boy number 2. Next up, we have Katizer, who will be presenting a showreel of a bunch of cool modded tasks made in 2023. Here we go.
I'm Cass.
That growl did not work like I wanted it to. God dang it. Alright, I knew it wouldn't. Okay, so tassing is very collaborative, at least with our tools. It's not to say that other endeavors in this game aren't, of course not, but after some discussion, instead of a best tasker of the year, we the task community opted for a task showcase, highlighting cool moments from some of the best tasses. 2023 was an excellent year for tassing, but with SJ, obviously. And also many other collabs, contests, and maps releasing and getting task projects. The community is in a healthy place too, with many new faces and record activity. There was a small task contest in February, and there were even a couple task puzzle maps made and beaten. And, you know, Stunning got discovered and then abused thoroughly last year, but let's just pretend that doesn't exist. As always, do consider trying tassing. It's a fun and unique way of playing, and the tools are easy to use. So, enjoy the showcase. The first thing
All right, congrats to all those tassers. This award goes out to all the tassers out there saving frames and mods. Also, shout outs to the lads who have participated in the newfound task bounties over the past year. Appreciate it very much. And yeah, like Katizer said, if you're interested in tassing, go do that. It's fun. Next up, I'll pass up the mic over to one of the greatest collabners of our generation, Bissy. Oh, wait. 1 p.m. Maybe 9 will take over for Bissy.
No, Bissy, sorry. Yeah, I'll do it for Bissy. Unfortunately, Bissy has run into some internet problems. Alright, so in the wake of Bissy's internet, I will be giving this speech and improving it too, so let's hope it's good. But collab entry of the year. Many people play Celeste and just play the collabs. They're amazing, they're easy to jump into and just sink a ton of hours in. I remember when Spring Collab came out and it was the only thing I played for like 3 months. It's genuinely incredible, and how it's even more incredible how they just keep coming and the maps inside them just keep getting better. So without a further ado, let's see the nominees for Collab Entry of the Year. Alright, and the winner of Collab Entry of the Year is... The Solar Express by Soloini!
Hi, I'm alive. Okay, I'm gonna take that as a yes. Yeah, all right. I definitely don't expect to win this. I didn't prepare anything for this. I'd like to thank everyone in the Strawberry Jam team. I mean, you all are amazing. Yeah, I definitely would not have been able to make this without any of you. And especially all the playtesters, the artists, and of course Bitmo Botmo for the amazing music. Special shout-outs to Rin for bearing with the map over many, many iterations and playtesting it the entire time. I mean, what a champ. And this map was really an experience to make. I mean, having remade so many of the rooms over and over and just reiterating on it until I was like finally in a place where I was happy with it, and I'm really happy with how it turned out, and it's really amazing to see all the support that people have given it. I mean, I quite frequently look into a collab general in Celeste Quad, and it's not, it's pretty common, really, that I see people just, like, talking about the map or saying that they're really enjoying it, and I mean, That's really nice to see. So yeah, I'm glad people have really enjoyed it, and that it seems to have inspired some people to make similar stuff. I guess that's all. Thank you for having me. See ya.
Alright, thank you, Solomini, for that speech, and congrats on winning Collab Entry of the Year. Next up, we have another trailer, so hang tight for that. This time I'm getting interviewed.
Well, that was pretty cool. I will be doing the interviewing question part of this interview because Toho is a big part of this. So are we getting Paz Callan in here?
Hopefully. Let me ping just to make sure. Oh, double
while
ping.
We're waiting for Paz. Oh. Ah, there he is.
Sorry, I didn't know I was supposed to...
You're good. That was my bad. Thank you. But this looks awesome. Can you guys spend a minute just to tell us a little bit about this collab and CSR in general?
I mean, I guess I'll talk about CSR first. CSR is basically... It's just a list of custom... Just a list of custom maps curated and organized by difficulty. So, you know, people can play a ton of mods and feel a sense of progression as they beat them. I mean, the name is kind of misleading. It stands for Celeste skill rating, but it's not really what it is at all. It's just, you know, basically, it's like hard list, but easy, you know, and sorted by difficulty. Yeah.
So people familiar with CSR will know there is a ton of extra content that came out over the time through the DLCs. Does this collab contain those DLCs or just the original CSR?
It just contains maps within the sides mostly, but there is specifically one map that was in a DLC that was cut for Seaside. So it can, but they're not going to be that common, I guess.
All right, that's pretty cool. So we did see there was at least 30 maps, 30 rooms, my bad. Or was it 30 maps? 30 rooms?
30 rooms. Something? It's like a heart side. Basically,
so 30 rooms, is that a final map count or oh my god, this gets confusing, the maps and the rooms. Is that the final room count or are you guys planning to go beyond that?
It's not quite finished. I mean, this is kind of just like a for fun collab. We kind of just started it, you know, late last year, and we're just like, whenever we all get tired and bored of making rooms, we'll just release it.
That's awesome.
So we're getting kind of close to that point, I think, but you know, I still want to make a couple of rooms now that I have time after awards. I know there's other people. Yeah, I think it's, you know.
Hey, yo.
I would be a little scared, chat, but let's see if
it's
he can
a project.
Do
it. No, I'll make some easy. I'll make some intermediate screens, you know, wholesome build.
You know what you should do? You should make a perceptions room.
Oh my god. I'm not good with jump scares. I can't.
Well, you're going to hate the Five Nights at Freddy's interview. Oh, yeah, we did that one. all right, any last remarks?
Can I give a quick shout out to Sophie, who's made a bunch of rooms for the collab and is just based mapper in general for these things?
Awesome. And from Utoho?
I guess I just want to say, I guess I hope this project, you know, encourages people to check out, you know, more maps, because I know CSR is pretty daunting. There's a lot on there, so maybe a more small, focused, like, little bunch of maps might be more enticing to players. And it will be, the hard set will be organized by difficulty, so you can kind of just play until you're not able to play anymore. Like, you can play beginner, awesome. Then the intermediate screens, then the advanced screens, and you're like, eh, expert's a bit too much for me, then it's okay to drop out there.
The white hole philosophy that CKB has.
Yes. Alright, so everybody, that was Paz Callan and Celeste White Boy number 3. We're going to move on now. Thank you guys so much.
Thank you.
Thank you. I'm taking the mic back from you, White Boy number 500. Give me that. Alright. Up next, don't tell me you forgot about contests. To follow up CSR Collab and Collab Entry of the Year, we have Juctor presenting Contest Entry of the Year. Take it away.
Hi, everyone. I'm Juctor from Juctor, and I'm happy to present Contest Entry of the Year. So mapping contests have been a fascinating part of Modded Celeste for a few years now. Whether it is through dissecting all the nuances of dream blocks, creating the most immersive cityscapes you can dream of, or simply transforming a banger song into an even more banger Celeste map, there's a certain magic that just pops out when you get passionate mappers to exercise their creative muscles in new ways. And contests are also awesome events for sharing ideas and for getting newcomers interested in making maps. The community's attitude towards them is really positive, and people really do their best to help others who are working hard. So really, it's no wonder that a lot of really beloved and popular mappers today first started out participating in some of the older mapping contests. So in case you didn't know, last year we broke the record for most entries in a mapping contest, not only once, but 3 separate times. So you just know there were a lot of fantastic contest maps last year, and I'm happy that we get to showcase some of them today. So without further ado, here are your nominees for Contest Entry of the Year. Those were some fantastic maps that were nominated. And the winner for the Contest Entry of the Year award is Kingdom to Heaven by Rikio6. Congratulations.
Hi again. Yeah, I don't really know what to say. I'm kind of speechless right now. Kingdom to Heaven. Yeah, I guess shoutouts to Cast for hosting Expert Contest. It's like a phenomenal map pack. It's full of Expert and totally not Grandmaster maps. So definitely go check it out if you haven't, and you can play that type of difficulty. Because obviously if the contest didn't exist, Kingdom to Heaven wouldn't either. I've been up here already, so I don't want to like repeat my words. But you know, just once again, I'm super appreciative of this community. I think there's like so many talented individuals that have really pushed the limits of, you know, modding incredibly far, and I've learned like a ton from everyone. So glad I could give back to the community in that way. So really appreciate all the support. I think that's it. Thank you.
Cool, thanks so much. Two awards, this Ricky guy cannot be stopped. Alright, up next we have a community award again. Yeah, I'm just gonna jump right into this one and say that this would not exist without Nyan. Like, this whole thing. And I might not still be in the Celeste community.
You're gonna mute yourself right now.
Oh. What do you mean? I must unmute myself? Why?
You must unmute yourself because I want to see who the winner of this award is. Sorry if I cut you off, but I want to see who won.
Okay, fine.
You get it too, all right?
What? No, don't give this shit to me.
Okay, I need to give chat a little bit of context. So we were doing some run-throughs of the practice of the, just to make sure everything was right before we streamed. And I found out that there was an award going to me. And I was like, okay, this doesn't slide because Toho is just as amazing and puts in probably more work and just energy into Celeste as a whole. And I cannot just let him give me an award without giving him award. So I'm happily nominating him for the Nyan Award as well.
Well, let me go first at least, but I really appreciate it.
Whoops.
And no, it's fine. I love you. It's very funny. And I'm excited for what you have to say for me, but let's just do some role-based combat here.
Yes, sir.
Or turn-based combat. I might not still be in the Celeste community, or definitely not as involved as I am, if Nyan wasn't there to invite me to work on the November Direct back in 2021. With his charisma, commitment, and enthusiasm, he put in the work to make each Direct a very special event, inspiring me to do the same with all of this. For this project, he structured and decoed the entire lobby with some help from Spooky's brilliant asset work. He created a portion of the cute intro to the awards, and generally did a lot of small things that contributed to the overall coolness of the awards, including some of the custom interview sprites. But most importantly, he made working on this fun, cracking jokes, suggesting quirky little things to insert into the awards. Being endlessly supportive, he genuinely brightens up any project team he's a part of. But this is an award for 2023, right? Let's talk about 2023. Nyan hosted 3 directs, totaling up to over 2.5 hours of runtime. In one of those directs, he made the Lunaris trailer, which is genuinely one of the most beautiful love letters to a mod I've ever seen. He ran the Olympus News for basically the entire year and made each mod sound so enticing with his infectiously silly and heartfelt writing style. He performed duties as a Game Banana mod for the first half of the year. He hosted music translation contest and imaginary birthday contest, with music translation contest being one of the largest contests to date, mostly due to its accessibility and ingenious concept. By allowing each map to be released on Game Banana as a standalone, I truly believe that music translation contest revolutionized what a contest could look like. Some of the most interesting maps I played last year were in that contest. The 2-week mapping period and soft 3-room limit allowed for so many modders to just have fun and share their ideas fearlessly without worrying how long lobby dev was going to take or how their map would look stacked up against the rest in a space like that. Nyan did all this while making 18 maps over the course of the year. Some were grandiose, some were small, but his love for the craft shines through every single aspect of his work in the community, and the level of energy at which he shares that love has brought a stunningly bright amount of light into the community in 2023 and over the past few years. It has been my honor to... it's just been a blast to work on this with him. I am stoked to present the Nyan Award to you, Nyan.
Jesus Christ, man. Where's the hidden cameras? Like, this is insane. That was probably one of the oh my god, nicest things anyone has ever said about me, and I'm honestly honored that you've said it, and that means a lot to me. And I was like thinking throughout the thing that I'm gonna, like, after you're done talking, I'm gonna say something like, oh, you want to get dinner after this or something, but like, oh man, I don't even have the words. I'm extremely humbled and proud and of everyone in this community and of you, and I'm just so happy that that, you know, everyone feels this way, or at least you feel this way. It's just, fuck you for getting me to almost tear up, but I want to talk about you too, because for as much as I did, you probably did almost like maybe as much or more, or I don't even know the words. But off the, I didn't prepare this because I'm stupid, but off the top of my head, let's talk about the shit you've done. You worked on all the directs too. You planned the entire awards, CSR, the map daily thing, Wordle thing that I can't remember the name of off the top of my head. Like 15 other things that I can't think of, and just play testing a bunch of things and being there for people and being maybe not as goofy as me, but you sure try. You deserve this award as much as I do, and I'm so, so bummed out that you were using this as the test one, because I wanted you to get caught off by this live, but I'm happy that I'm able to give this to you regardless, and it's been more than a pleasure to work with you. Honestly, it's just amazing, and you're an amazing person.
I appreciate that very much. Probably sleeping.
I'll get him next time.
All right, banger.
All right, lock in.
lock in. All right, what's next?
I have no idea.
All right. Next up. Oh yeah, the winning animation. This should have been two of these people. Yeah, but that was. I appreciate that very much, and stop shipping us in the chat, please. Speaking of large projects. Time to let Carrarium take the stage and present the award for Collaborative Project of the Year.
Hey everybody, I'm Carrie Carrarium. It's nice to see all of you. So, if you boot up Vanilla Celeste, the very first thing you'll stumble across isn't the title screen, but rather a two-part introduction to the game. That reads, Extremely OK Games Limited presents a game by Maddie, Noel, Amora, Pedro, Lena, Kevin, and friends. Two words that encapsulate one of the most important aspects of artistic credit and recognition. That more often than not in game design, there's more going on under the hood. Everyone who had a hand in creating this game, regardless of their position, has a seat at the table. The title screen. It recognizes that Celeste is a collaborative effort, and one that the Celeste community continues proudly to this day. Countless collabs and contests have been released over the years, but no matter what the gimmick or the theme of it is, each one of them carries that same attitude that EXOK proudly displays. And friends. No matter your involvement in the production or how long you've been around the community, collabs and contests give everyone a seat at the table and a place to be celebrated for creating something. Collabs and contests celebrate creativity, and the community at large benefits by having more of the game we love. And with all that in mind, here are the nominees for Collaborative Project of the Year.
Hey
And the winner of the Collaborative Project of the Year award is Strawberry Jam. Congratulations, everybody. Great job.
All right, Gamation, do you want to hop in here? But because Bissy isn't available, I do have a speech to read from Aiden. Hey, everyone. I'm so proud of the work we did for Strawberry Jam. Each and every developer can relish in what we collectively made. If there's any lesson Strawberry Jam taught us, it's that the community can make great things when it comes together, and I'm honored that our work was recognized as the pinnacle of that this year. I know SJ is big, but there is some fierce competition for this award. I love every one of you that has made this possible, and cherish some of the lifelong friends I hope I've made through it. P.S. Go climb rocks.
Everyone, I'm Gamation, and I completely agree with everything Aiden had to say. I'm here to share a message from Bissy due to the power loop being out, which is the following. Strawberry Jam was such a ginormous project across the Celeste community, so much so that it's hard to succinctly choose words while accepting this award to represent all the people that worked on it. It took years and thousands of hours of work and effort, and it's honestly still so surreal to see that it came out even a year later. I honestly struggle to think of what to say. I never thought that the project would grow as big as it is today. It's something that now so many people hold dear in their heart. Nearly everyone who worked on Strawberry Jam has a unique, passionate perspective on it. But I think there are two things that I can say that truly represent what all of the Strawberry Jam developers are thinking, so I'll keep it short. To every single person that worked on Strawberry Jam, thank you so much for all the work you did on it. And to everyone that played it, thank you for wanting to experience what we made. I'd also like to add, for myself, that it's baffling to me that Strawberry Jam has been out for a year. It seems like just the other day, we were designing puzzles, drawing cat friends and pride flags, making crabs grabbable, and so much more. The past year has been nothing short of insane for all of us. We've seen our not-so-little mod project amass hundreds of thousands of downloads, have fan art and fan music made of it, raise $12,500 for charity, and most recently be shown on the big screen at GDQ. On behalf of all 350 developers, I am so, so, so grateful for everyone that propelled SJ to the heights that it has reached, and we're beyond excited to see what happens next. Thank you so much.
Yeah, thank you so much. I mean, it generally changed the landscape of Celeste forever, and in the most epic way possible, so huge congrats. Alright, we're entering the last five awards now. Scribbles Jevson will now present the Art Direction of the Year award.
Alright. Okay. Hey everyone, it's me, Jeffson, or better known as Scribbles. I believe art direction is a very big building block for Celeste mods. Not to say as like a necessity not a necessity for every Celeste mod ever. It's not like something that can just be said that is objectively needed for a mod, of course, or like I don't believe that should be there shouldn't be nothing that's like objectively needed for a mod ever. It's like what you choose to be needed and what is not needed. It's like all the mapper's choice and what I believe. Alright. But it can really help increase players' enjoyment and or appreciation of someone's work. And I think a good example to start with, that pretty much everyone knows about, would be Glyph. Glyph has a very vibrant, volatile, otherworldly style to it, with areas that are very beautiful looking, and solid grounds that help give a feeling of depth and realness. But then there's interludes that are more empty. Empty in a sense that it's meant to be a void of some sort. However, it feels much more interesting and mysterious due to the vibes the map is giving us prior, which I think is a great example of how effective this is, especially considering Glyph mainly uses vanilla tile sets with some recolors. It still invokes such an interesting vibe with things that can be seen as more simple or basic. And that's what makes art direction so beautiful. It's not really a singular thing, it's a multitude of things. Everything can have a role in increasing the effectiveness of art direction, whether it be decals, tile sets, style grounds, and whatnot. It can have some great significance in the structure of people's maps. So even when something is less focused on, it can still be made up for by focusing on our aspects. So I hope I've given this topic justice with this speech, and I'll see the nominations. taking from that. And the winner of the Art Direction of the Year award is Banana Mountain by Banana.
All right, congrats to Banana 23. Unfortunately, he cannot be here today, but again, I have the speech. Banana 23 says, "Hello. I want to say how thankful I am to accept this award. I want to say thanks to all the Winter Collab and Zucchini Chord members for giving an insane amount of feedback on the visuals of the map. A major reason for the map even looking an ounce as good as it does is because of the countless times they were able to give feedback on incredibly minor things. It's also thanks to their feedback both during and before the production of the campaign that I had the skills needed to create the visuals the campaign has. So all in all, major props to them and everybody else in the community who's out there and passionate about the game. They make the community incredible and are part of the reason I make Celeste stuff as well. Open colon, wholesome 1000, close colon." Yeah, Banana is one of the most wholesome and nice people in the community, and it's, you know, generally amazing to see them get a win like this. And Banana Mountain is one of the new mods that I just give to everybody who's starting out in modded Celeste, because it's just so full of heart and beautiful. But up next, we have the very last trailer with an interview. Reminder that we'll have 10 more trailers after the awards are over, but this is the last big trailered interview. And without further ado, here we go. Alright, Santa. We have Santa himself for this interview.
You're unmuted, dude.
Hello, we have Santa himself for this interview.
Oh, ho, ho, Merry Celestmas. I have two big,
elves in my bag. They're gonna come out now.
it was so dark in there.
It's not free.
Oh, it's the actual host of Secret Santa Collab. How are you guys?
I'm good.
Juice, do you want to go first, or should I?
I mean, it depends how Toho, the question Toho wants to ask us.
Alright, first question. Wait. Actually, I might need to refactor these. I made them too jokey for Santa.
Oh.
Wait, how many maps? Are you two okay? Like, how were you able to pull this off?
It's a collab. It's everything here is a group effort. For those who don't know, how Secret Santa Collab works is that you have everyone put in a prompt for some other person, and everyone else makes a map for that other person. I guess I'm going to put that out there beforehand. And this is an incredibly cooperative experience. Everyone working with everyone together. I think I want to thank everyone for helping me and Bossos and the other mysterious host just get through this. I guess that's if that answers your question.
If I add on to that, the only reason this was possible was because of just how many awesome people we had in the collab. I have to give a personal shout out to Spooky, who is undoubtedly the MVP of the collab. They made so much art, helped decorate so many maps. So much. Spooky is just the GOAT, the MVP. Love you, Spooky.
Roughly what difficulties are in each lobby again, for those who are not aware?
It's split across three lobbies. There's a beginner to intermediate lobby, advanced to expert, and then the everything else. It gets tricky. But only there. That's the easiest stuff for those who want that.
Nice. Aside from the map count, are there any significant differences between other Secret Santa collabs? Or is this pretty much the same sort of vibe?
I feel like this year we had a lot of very long maps. There are, off the top of my head, like 3 or 4 maps that have more than 50 rooms, which is absolutely insane. We also handled like lobby entrances and stuff a bit differently this year. A thing we like to do each year is just try to like do something unique. So like the first year we had the presents. Second year we had the different like shops, and this year I'm not gonna reveal what it is, but it's pretty cool.
It'll be like the holidays. You'll open up the collab, and it's about what's in the presents there. So
yeah,
nice. I'm pretty excited. If my ears do not deceive me, that sounded like a new Intika song in the trailer. Is there a similar amount of custom music in this collab as Secret Santa 2023?
I think there's more.
Yeah, more. Not only that, we love you, Intikis. But Intikis did so much work last year. This year we have so many like talented artists coming together. Not just Intikis, so many cool people coming together. I just think that's worth mentioning.
Yeah.
Nice. You couldn't come up with many questions, because if you know Secret Santa, you know the deal. If you're excited for this and haven't played previous Secret Santas, I highly encourage you check them out. They're some of the most incredible modding content this game has to offer. But do you all have anything you want to say?
I need to give a special thanks to Goose for first off coming up with the original like Secret Santa thing. I'm just an imposter. I'm just trying to be like them. Seriously, I think Secret Santa would not be where it is today. I don't even think it would exist if Goose had not just done everything. I'd like to think I'm an all right host, but Goose is like just above and beyond. So thank you so much. It's been a pleasure working with you.
Well, thank you. I'm blushing. And I kind of covered this earlier, but think about a collab. I'd like to give the extended thank you to just everyone, literally everyone. If you're in the server, thank you all so much for all your helping you've been doing. That's what makes this collab so different from anything else really in Celeste. It's for each other. It's for people. It is, Thank you for
the nice.
Collab, by the way,
nice. Thank you guys so much. I'm glad you were able to make it, and I'm super excited.
Oh, back in my bag.
No.
No. All right. Well, good luck, Santa. I hope, you know, a starving kid needs those two people somewhere across the world. All right. Now here to present debut motto of the year, we have senior citizen Buff Zucchini. Take it away.
You didn't say anything.
Hi, I'm a Buff Zucchini. I'm so old. Hold on, where is it? It's been super cool over the years to see new people come into the community. Wait, I just realized I have to mute the tab. I can hear myself. It's been super cool to have people come into the community over the past while, bringing all these new ideas, all their new perspectives, new art styles, new gameplay ideas. It's been super cool to see all of that show itself in maps the past year. It's just so much new and cool, unique stuff, and it's so nice to see. And yeah, it's been cool to see people be able to, you know, put in the effort to fit themselves right in, find their niche, that thing that helps them stand out, and yeah, roll the nominations.
Oh my gosh. This is nuts. I mean, this kind of feels weird because I feel like I've been around for a fair bit now, but it was, like, I've been involved in so many things, so many cool things, but I guess it was, yeah, only actually last year that I released my first map. I mean, yeah, I'm honored. I'm glad that I seem to be providing, you know, cool stuff for the community. This is definitely one of the best communities I've ever been a part of. When I was working on the Sentient Forest, I'd absolutely no experience in anything game dev related, so I'd never done, you know, level design, gameplay, artwork. I'd never done art before, storytelling, 3D modeling, anything like that. So many firsts, and I had a bunch of questions, as you can imagine, when I first started. I still do, to be honest. I'm always asking questions, always learning. There's no shame in that, really. We're just super lucky to have such an accessible modding scene, because it is so easy to get into, like, relatively. Like I said, I've never done any of this before. Shoutouts to, like, the Everest team, who develop all these crazy useful tools that are super easy to use. Cruor and Vex for all their work on the editors. And, you know, all the insanely cool people that are making helpers for mappers to use, because the mappers get all the credit normally, but, you know, people who make the helpers, they're the ones making stuff happen and giving us the cool tools to make cool stuff. This is definitely the most enjoyable hobby I've had, and I've learned a hell of a lot doing it, and interacted with so many cool people. So, thanks, I guess, and I hope I'll be around for a while. Thank you.
yeah, my bad. I totally forgot.
You're in the wrong channel, dude.
Huh?
You're in the wrong one.
What does that mean? Oh, my bad.
No, I told it to come back and make a joke. Oh, oops. Well, that's my goat. That's my goat, Buff Zucchini. Who better to present the upcoming Formidable Award than Parrot Dash, a certified Grandmaster?
Hello everyone, I'm Parrot, and I'm here to announce the Formidable Award. This award is dedicated to my personal favorite type of maps, Grandmaster and Grandmaster Plus difficulty maps. These difficulties are cool because there's basically no limit. Any complex, crazy ideas you can come up with are fair game. There are basically infinite level design possibilities when it comes to Grandmaster difficulty levels, since you can use all the tech the game has to offer. As someone with over 5,000 hours in this game that's still constantly learning new things, I can guarantee there's always another niche interaction around the corner in GM maps. This, combined with the fact you can make gameplay as input dense or difficult as you want, makes for some of the most satisfying and creative maps. However, mappers need a solid mechanical understanding of the game and a lot of experience to be able to craft something that plays and flows smoothly. If you're able to pull that off, you can unlock the deepest potentials of Celeste. And oh boy, do we have some talented people in our community. 2023 has brought about some of the coolest custom content I've seen in any game. So with that, here are the nominees for the Formidable Award. And the winner of the Formidable Award is... Superfecta! Congratulations.
Alright, all members of Superfecta, you can join the voice call.
Hi! Is it just me and Zucchini in here?
I know that Goose and Kaz won't be able to make it. Or maybe Goose will, but Kaz won't.
There's Goose.
Oh, there we go.
I can
well, before this, Apple's speech is the same as last time, so they're super grateful to people hosting the awards and anybody who has passionate or is passionate about Celeste in general. So, oh, also sorry, Zucchini, I didn't tell Nyan that you were coming in.
It's totally fine. It was kind of giggling.
But I'll let you guys handle it.
I mean, what is there even to say?
Yeah.
I'm happy that this project got nominated. I'm glad that the amount of support that this project specifically has gotten is just crazy to me. I love how much people adore this map. It's cool to pop into the servers and see people going this is one of the best maps I've ever played. All five of these people cooked equally. I'm like, wow, that's awesome.
Yeah, I think there's something you said about the communal aspect of things. That is what made this map for me in the creating process. I think you should make maps with your friends. Get together, get your friends. Go make however many rooms long. I think that's what made the experience for me. I also want to give a shout out to Haikim, who made the music in the map. And that definitely brought a whole new aspect to things. Haikim is, in my mind, the sixth member of the Superfecta.
100%.
Yeah.
Music is what kept me wanting to map for this.
Exactly.
School and everything going on. That's what kept that taking a higher priority. Maybe it shouldn't have.
That's fine.
I lived.
Yeah. Well, I mean, I guess everyone's has said their speech already. For me personally, Superfecta was definitely probably my favorite collab experience I've had in Celeste. Many collabs with friends, these are just super fun because everyone's responsive and then they're all motivated to make stuff. The vibes are good. So yeah. Once also shout outs, same as Goose, shout outs to Tykem for the music. It was incredible. I think they made
four or how many songs? It was like, it was three songs and then three two songs, of them had like,
yeah.
Two of them had like different progressions and this was done in the course of like, oh, right. The last one does too. Yeah, it was done in the course of like, I don't know, like a week or something. It was insane. But yeah.
Surprise, I can actually talk this time. This is Apples. So, I just wanted to say something quick. I mean, you already heard my speech earlier when I got the other award, but I think something I genuinely would like to see more in Celeste modding is like maps that are sort of done in a similar format where a bunch of friends get together and map something and, you know, well, friends map and make a collab, but it's not like necessarily collab structured, it's just the map multiple people worked on. Because like, I think all of those projects that have been made like that have turned out really well, and I think people enjoy them a lot. So it's just, you know, if you're getting into mapping, or maybe you're already a mapper, then I really would like recommend doing something like this sometime. It really is a lot of fun, and usually turns out very well.
Yeah, thank you all so much. And
all I wanted to say.
I'm planning on reading out your message, Kaz. Just be patient. I'm cooking. But okay, Kaz says, "Hey, pretty cool to win this. There are a ton of absolute bangers of maps in this category that deserve this award, so to see that people really resonated with our silly project is so awesome to see. Really, the main thing to focus for me here is the great time I had making this map with my friends. It was stressful as heck at times, but the banter, all the ideas thrown around, and just the experience of helping each other where we could was just such a nice experience. And it's great to see people that the result of that is a map that so many people love. I'm super happy with the project, and I'm sure all the people who worked on this feel the same way, so thanks for the award. Simply put, shoutouts to Ricky, Zucchini, Goose, Apples, Tykim, and everybody else who helped put this mod together. And thanks to everyone who has said nice things about the map, or is just hyping up when they can. We really appreciate it. So yeah, that's it. Thank you. Also, Free Palestine. Based.
Taurus, I was gonna ask, can we get the award cut into like 6 evenly shaped things, just so we can, you know, mail that all out to the people.
Look, you'll have to do that on your end. I'm busy. I'm busy, so I don't have any cutting tools because the government won't allow me.
Yeah, but thank you again. Thank you so much.
Yeah, thanks again. All right. Next, we have another community award. So this is the final community award. It's a bit different. Each year, a lifetime achievement award will be given out to a community member who has contributed significantly to the community over the course of multiple years and has generally shown a consistent dedication and love for the game. This year's lifetime achievement award goes to I am Dadbod. Dadbod has made hundreds of Celeste videos over the past few years, not always playing the most critically acclaimed maps, but always taking the time to check out, showcase, and promote a new random map on Game Banana that caught his eye. A lot of the underlying principles of I am Dadbod's content inspires what I do and how I approach project creation in general. Dadbod is and has always been about building up modders, giving positive feedback and well-worded suggestions with a genuine smile, regardless of how frustrated he may have gotten while playing. His constructive approach was always a warm intro to his videos, and like many, inspired to check out many mods I would have never given a chance otherwise. However, we haven't even gotten started. I am Dadbod's Ahorn tutorials proved to be the most cohesive, accessible, and effective tutorial to Celeste map making for multiple years on end. Without the care and effort he put into explaining and visually demonstrating all aspects of Ahorn, who knows how many modders would have gotten too confused by the program to get started. I am Dadbod also hosted an entire collab in 2018, allowing a ton of modders to get together, schmooze, and start building up a real community that would lead to the inception of Spring Collab. I mean, I really don't have to sit here and ramble for 70 minutes about how Spring Collab fully kicked this community into high gear with the incredible exposure it brought and the general experience of a perfect introduction to modded Celeste. I will, however, ramble about the post-Spring Collab prompt contests he hosted with Big Kahuna, those being Halloween Contest, New Year's Contest, Valentine's Contest, Height Contest, and Unexpected Behaviors Contest. These short-form bursts of mapping energy brought a lot of modders together who now comprise many of the seasoned, multi-talented veterans of 2024. The general idea of mapping contests didn't really exist until I Am Dadbod and Donker19 helped popularize them, making them a staple of the community's output each year. Additionally, his initial Strawberry Jam announcement video was the driving force behind most applications to the project. On so many levels, I Am Dadbod's positive influence on the state of modding is undeniable, and it is my honor to present this year's Lifetime Achievement Award to I Am Dadbod. Thanks so much. Up next, Simonius will be presenting Modder of the Year.
From today's show, we've already seen that 2023 was an incredible year for Celeste modding. It's a scene that keeps improving every single year with more and more amazing works of art. Of course, this is all thanks to the people behind it. Without mappers, coders, artists, and musicians, and everyone else, none of it would ever be possible. Personally for me, it's been a blast interacting with the community, and they've led me to make some maps of my own. Playing through maps like Strawberry Jam, Superfacta, UFO Nest, and tons of other maps have been some of the best experiences I've had in gaming, period. It truly feels like every map is something new to bring to the table. So yeah, suffice to say, it's been nothing but inspiring to me to see the community develop with all the great people in it. Some people really went the extra mile to make the Celeste community something special, though. Be it the developer of an incredible map, the heart behind a great collab, or anything else to contribute, this award is for the person who had the biggest impact on the modding scene over the last year. Let's see the nominees for the 2023 Modder of the Year. And the modder of the year is a buff zucchini.
Let's go. One second. Sorry, my dad showed me a video. Yeah, I did. Can people hear me good?
You're good.
Yeah, cool. All right. Is it like speech time? Perfect. I'm so, so happy that I won this. I love all of you. I did not prepare a speech, so I'm going to say things. Shit, yeah. This community has like changed me. It's like reformed me as a person. I'm so different from like when I started making things for this. I've met so many amazing people and made so many incredible connections. And it just means so much to me to, you know, have that recognized, and I've be able to make these connections and all that. Like, yeah, no, I have no way. Sorry, just stream on pause for a second and a little bit Planet Music started playing. Yeah, this... wow, yeah, no words. But thank you, everyone who, you know, organized the awards and all that, and for everyone who's helped me along the way. I want to give a big shout out to Goose for being, like, I don't know, the number one person who's always been there to do Celeste stuff with me over the years. Big motivation for, like, just their big motivation creatively, if that makes sense. Alright, I have nothing else to say. I'm just speechless. Thank you, everybody. Good luck with the rest of the awards.
Thanks. Congrats. You definitely deserve it. I mean, with Ukraine, insane amount of maps this year, and yeah, absolute legend. Finally, we now have the final award being presented by Boss Sauce, Campaign of the Year.
Hello, are we good now? yo, I'm Boss Sauce. I make maps for the game Celeste. I said the thing. I have escaped Nyan's scary and evil bag, and I'll be presenting Campaign of the Year. As cool and as hype as collabs are, campaigns and standalone maps have paved the way for some of the most creative things ever conceived. Unlike collabs, there are basically no limits to what can be made, no time constraints, no room limits, and nobody to tell you if you've gone too far. Some of the most mind-bendingly awesome and polished maps, as well as some of the most insane and unhinged things, have been the result of one person left their own devices without any restraint. This year has been an awesome year for standalones, with so many new and amazing mappers jumping onto the scene, as well as older mappers who still continue to grow to this day. I'm genuinely super excited to see the future of standalones. Well, enough blabbing. Here are your nominees. And the winner for Campaign of the Year is, drumroll please, The Solaris System by Donker19.
Oh my gosh. I'm so happy. I guess I wrote out a speech for this already. I guess I'll just read it out. When I first started creating mods 5 years ago, with my first mod for Second Temple in 2019, I was just 14 years old. I had no idea what it would turn into. But now I'm here, accepting an award for the thing that I've worked my hardest on for 3 years. For the thing that was looming above me for that time, for the thing I hated and cried about, for the thing that I laughed and smiled about, and for the thing that defined my life for years. I'm in shock, and although that probably does have something to do with this award itself, I'm also in shock because you have come so far. You watching this, everyone here, we've grown so much, we all have. I still remember when I began work on Solaris in 2020, I rolled it out within 2 months of starting it. For its time, it was alright, I poured my soul into it, projecting a version of myself into Ahorn, after it loaded for 5 minutes, of course. And I did the exact same thing for Lunaris, Better Time, Solaris, Red Space, and the Jash fight, the full clear golden endings, the stories, and every little other thing that I put into the Solaris Dark Side update, Lunaris, whatever you want to call it. I feel like the chapter of Lunaris itself is extremely special to me. I still remember having the vivid imagery of darkness and blue tiles with purple backgrounds when Luma jokingly mentioned that I should do Lunaris a couple days after Solaris came out in 2020. I started it just a week or so later, and it remained on my workstation for so long. The cool part about this is that you can actually see my mapping style evolve throughout the chapter. I've improved so much since then. Take a look at the final checkpoint. Those final 6 flags of Lunaris. Those are some of my best works I've ever done in the Celeste community, and you can really see that. The intro rooms are alright. I mean, I had to go back and tweak them a lot. But you can just see in the chapter it improves as it goes on. Not to mention the secrets. I mean, Red Space, semi-inspired by Glyph's cool, season side secret, is one of, if not the coolest thing I've done in the game. Then I worked on Better Times and Stellaris most recently, which are also very good, better than most of Lunaris in my opinion. In just 3 years, I've gotten so much better at this craft, and I'm proud of myself for that. Improvement's possible for anyone, in any field, really. For a while, I felt like my mapping was inadequate, and I'm sure any artist can relate to this feeling. People judge free works of passion harshly, and you see this all the time in Celeste, even today. However, even if that hindered my progress, it didn't stop it. The truth is, humans are progressing and improving all the time, people, you and me. The story of Solaris Better Times literally shows Madeline reflecting on her past, feeling like nothing has changed in her character over the years, and that all her mistakes were for nothing. Obviously, this was a feeling I had for a while, too. Every author injects themselves into their work, consciously or not. But I started to realize that things are different. Change happens in small amounts over time, and you clearly learn through your mistakes. In Better Times, I use the analogy of a stained glass mural. We break and use the broken pieces of ourselves to make us better and more beautiful. We've come so far. You're not who you were 5 years ago. Or 3. Or 1. Or 6 months, or even a week. The first step to self-improvement is realizing that it's possible to change. I'm sorry. I struggled a lot in 2020, and I'm sure that's no secret. Solaris is one of the first mods to attempt to tackle a more serious story about mental illness. I'm sorry that the dialogue was juvenile, but I myself was juvenile. I was simply projecting onto Madeline, and everyone who has tried to write a serious story for a Celeste mod has done this too. Solaris was a way to vent my frustrations, fears, and hardships, and that's why I love Celeste modding so much. It helped me find solace in a really hard time for myself. I'm still here, and so are you. We've made it. And we still have a long way to go. Everyone who has played Stellaris, the seaside of Solaris, knows that the ending song is Anna Managuchi's amazingly catchy and groovy prom night. Well, that night is actually for me tonight. My senior prom is in an hour. Talk about a coincidence, right? But I think this is a perfect opportunity to look to the future. I'm about to graduate high school. Some of you are in similar boats. Some still have time before that, and some are long beyond this. But this is a huge step. Everyone's taking huge steps, and I'm scared. It's okay to be scared. It's okay that I'm scared. I could spend hours reminiscing on old times, old friends, old loves, and old experiences. But that's ultimately not productive. Instead, I'm gonna focus on the depth of my growth from here on out, so that I can keep growing. And everyone, regardless of where they are in their life, should too. Growth is possible. And you've been doing it your entire life. You know, in my next paragraph and the ones following it, but I don't really think it will be for me, so I'm sorry. I now want to take the time to really state how much I value everyone in the community. I mean, seriously, you people are all so amazing. it's evident this, that this community really cares about one another. I don't really, like, see this anywhere else in any other community for anything. I remember when Dabbod fostered me and encouraged me to keep working on mods. One of my best friends, Safe, playtested Solaris and loved it. We've been besties ever since. And between you and me, I asked her to playtest more so we could get to know each other better. Neb was such a great person to be around during these early days. Even Moon was an incredible friend for me. The Winter Collab crew, mediocre comedians, popular mapping clique, whatever you want to call them, have gotten me through hard times as well. Careless Anonymous, okay, Nano. Sunset Quasar, Banana, Mindma, Juno, Bissy, Dantigayo, and Rue have all been incredible friends I've made throughout this community. Rue actually joined me at an anime convention a while back, and that was super fun. But even after Winter Collab, I've met so many great people. Nyan, one of my closest and funniest people. Goose, Zucchini, and Ricky, three amazingly talented people who continue to amaze and inspire me. Bauer AV, Gamation, Kaz, Toho, Grayscale, Tardigrade, Rinjast, Unknown, Atobia, Caterpillar, and Shirley Shrimple are also friends I've made that I love very much, as well as those who helped me even make Lunarus. Maddie 480 with the coated jellyfish, Juno again with some sick custom sprites and tunes, the Dev Smasher with Lua help, Caterpillar with the outro music, and Ricky 06 for the in-screen art of Lunarus, and Neb for the in-screen art of Solaris, of course, and all my playtesters, and my amazing girlfriend Feather, the one who's coming to prom with me. You really helped me mature, and I'm so happy that you're in my life. I don't know what I'd do without you. All of these wonderful people, all those that I didn't mention here, I love you. You've helped me grow into who I am today. You've helped me complete and release my magnum opus. The solar system, lunar, stellar, whatever you... were really special to me real quick. I don't know if she's watching this, but my friend Safe, I'm speaking to you now. You've been my closest friend for the past 4 years. You were there during some of my darkest times and moments, and you helped me power through the development of the original Solaris. You're always so supportive of my work, and I'm so happy you exist. We've gone through so much together, and I remember that time I was sick with something very painful for 2 weeks. I streamed Night of the Woods for you, and you watched, and we played Minecraft together. And I'll never forget all the memories and moments we've had together like this. You inspire me every day with your resilience and talent, and I genuinely don't know if I would be alright today if you were not in my life. You're such an incredible light of laughter and a joy for me. Like, genuinely, I've probably laughed the hardest and most with you out of any other person. I'm so happy to call you a friend. I'm so proud of you. I love you so much. And, I know this is kind of like the Nyan show, but Nyan, I gotta add you too, man. You literally edited one of the best trailers in the community ever for my little map, Lunarus, and you did it exactly like I wanted perfectly. You did it so much better than I ever could. And I remember that night, like 3 days before Lunarus released, we were up late in VC from 4 hours until 2 a.m. We laughed so hard, we watched the Billy Bust Up trailer, and you helped me make Lunarus truly special. And you just make every day so special for me. I always think of your silly comments at least once a day, and they always make me smile. You shaped me into the person I am today, and I love you so much. And I've just got a couple more paragraphs, guys. I'm really sorry. I had a lot to say. I wanted to say. But right now, I'd like to especially thank Nyan again, and Toho. They poured their hearts into this award show, and it's incredible. I'm so proud of both of them. It's been amazing for, like, everyone watching. Like, I don't think I've ever seen anything this high quality, like, related to Celeste on YouTube before. It's incredible. It's just a celebration of so many amazing people and such an amazing community, and you guys really put this together. I saw someone earlier say you guys are the backbone of the community, and I really do think that's true. I don't think it would be how it is without you two. Yeah. And I want to thank everyone who supported me along the way. Everyone who enjoyed my mod enough to nominate it for Campaign of the Year. You changed my life. Life was hard for me for a very, very long time. Now it's easier. Now it's more enjoyable. Celeste helped me grow into who I am today. I actually wrote my college essay on the development of some of my Celeste mods, and I got into my 14% acceptance rate dream school with it. This is by no means a useless hobby, and don't let anyone ever tell you it is. My mom will often refer to me modding as playing a game, which yeah, she's right. But it's much more than that. I'm creating artwork, I'm writing stories, I'm gaining leadership skills, friendships, connections, and I'm even learning how to love. It's changed me and my life so much, and I can't understate that enough. It genuinely boggles my mind how much this game has helped me be better. Soon I'm off to college, that Celeste literally helped me get into, and I'm so excited for this next part of my life. And you know how I said at the end of the Lunar's trailer that would be my last major Celeste project? Well, that's true. I think I'm done for now. Maybe I'll do the occasional Fine Room beginner, intermediate map, whatever, but I'm satisfied with what I've done. I'm proud of what I've done. I'll still be here in the community, just not making stuff anymore. I need to focus on other things. And I hope I was able to make a positive impact on your life with my work. Thank you all very much for this award. I'm honored to call you my community. You're incredible, and never forget your worth. Thank you. I'm sorry I went so long.
No, you're perfectly good, man. That was a beautiful, beautiful, beautiful speech to, you know, cap off the awards. You crushed it, and, you know, you absolutely deserve this award. This campaign means so much to so many people, and it's truly a transcendent work of art, so thank you.
I'm glad that you and so many others think that. Thank you.
I love you, man.
I love you, too.
All right. Yeah, that was amazing. And with that, the main part of the awards is over. We still have a wonderful epilogue video and 10 more trailers. Wait, no, 11 more trailers to go after all of this. So, I mean, just thank you all so much for watching. Thank you for putting up with the audio issues and some of the lag in the first 15 minutes. Really appreciate it. I do plan on releasing, you know, a little more polished version of the awards on YouTube. Maybe tomorrow morning, like I'll go in there, I'll fix, you know, some of the overlapping, you know, audio from my laptop doing some of the trailers, and you know, fix sound balancing, and, you know, maybe go into Audacity and shift some stuff around. But yeah, everybody, thank you so much for watching. I mean, thanks to everybody who took part in this. Like, this is insane. Like, everybody made this so much more than the sum of its parts. I'm kind of unscripted right now, so I'm rambling, but I'm so, so happy that this turned out the way it did, and it's because of every single one of you. It's truly incredible to be in this community every single day, to play the newest mod on Game Banana. I don't care what it is. It's just so incredible to see every single person, you know, just putting their all into this community. And I mean, you know, I'm here to stay. I plan to, you know, make the next award show even more polished. And it's just incredible. I mean, I hope this outro video will showcase some of my feelings for me, but I mean, just, you know, going off Donker's speech right there, just this whole Celeste thing means so much to so many people. I mean, it's just, it is really, it's beyond explanation. I can't put it into words. But I hope to continue supporting this community, and huge congrats to everybody who won an award, everybody who's nominated, you know, everybody who made a mod in 2023. It's no small feat, and I've seen firsthand the amount of work these people put into their art, and it baffles me, you know. So yeah, just thanks so much, and without further ado, here's the epilogue.
Thank you. It's that time of the year again. Spring has sprung. MTC2 is cool and all, but there's even more music translation to get excited about. This Mavlik has some quirks that you'll need to see to believe. Relax those shoulders and get ready for the most chill and wholesome map that's being premiered today. Hey.
I already loved dense swap block gameplay, but now with Gravity Helper? Extended Variants fans, you are about to witness flames. The most whimsical plant-based campaign just got a bit meatier. We'll be right back. To quote the great Juctor, 2024 is the year of minigames in Celeste. A long-lost FLCC map is almost ready to be uncovered. Most lovers rejoice because there's some new, beautifully structured claustrophobia on its way.
Thank you.
Super Dash rightfully receives the disco party it deserves in this pulse-pounding map.
Well, there you have it. Thanks to everybody who submitted a trailer for this. Those are truly some epic stuff. And, you know, I look forward to playing all of those when they come out. So, thanks so much. As for credits, I didn't really go deep into this enough at the end of the awards, but yeah, the Fan Game Awards were a huge inspiration for this. Like, they're awards program that they set up is just so beautiful and heartfelt, and just everything, you know, I think a lot of the success this awards show received tonight, you know, with the speeches from the nominees and the speeches from the winners and the nomination videos and the interspersed trailers and the community awards, a lot of those ideas came from the Fan Game Awards, and they all work beautifully. I mean, who would have guessed? It's just a really, really tight, amazing structure for a program like this, and it, you know, it helped make this what it could be, but obviously it couldn't be what it was without every single modder and announcer and everyone just being so heartfelt and taking it, you know, just as seriously as I took it, and still being silly with it, you know, when was fitting and fun, and it was amazing. I want to thank the coders who helped code all those cutscenes, Viv and Luna, for, you know, just making sure those flowed seamlessly and that it was easy to, you know, edit around with OBS. I didn't have to do too much work. I just had to fade in and out and stuff. I think my main nerf was having only one monitor. You know, it's kind of hard to run this sort of thing with one monitor. But I'm still very happy with how this turned out, and I hope I can get the kind of polished, you know, no audio issues version in by tomorrow morning. And yeah, big shout outs to Nyan and Pookie Lou. I mean, I've already talked tons about Nyan, but Pookie Lou edited like maybe like 10, no, like 14 or something of those nominations videos, and, you know, they all look incredible. Like, I mean, the one thing I regret is not recording enough footage. I had to take some from YouTube, and I didn't expect how choppy it would get, you know, when run through After Effects, but we didn't really have time. But next year I want to release this around mid-February instead of April, because that's just more fitting. People will, mods from the last year will stick in people's heads a bit more. And even so, I think we'll have more time to work on it than we did this year, just because I didn't quite understand what I was doing. There was a lot of learning curves, and, you know, I've organized a ton of stuff, but even this is, you know, way bigger, it's way grander. It takes a lot more effort, and I will be looking for more, you know, helpers next year for anybody who's down. Oh, yep. I mean, I didn't make the video last long enough to sustain a speech like this, but... yeah, I mean, what else? Oh, Olive. Olive, thanks for recording the clips for Amoeba and... something. Another hardless map that I can't play. Dragonfruit Demise. And, yeah. I think I stole some footage from Glantis and JoJo... as well. And yeah, I mean, Gamation's YouTube videos, although they unfortunately didn't process super well in After Effects, were essential to, you know, getting this completed. Without them, it would be so tough to have to record everything. But next year, we'll try to make that happen. Spooky created the 3D model that was used in most of the nominations videos. It's so beautiful and just, you know, just like a 1 second GIF loop of like what this award means, you know, in so many ways. It's just so much effort put into this like small little thing, and it's great. It's very great. But if anybody has any questions, I can answer them right now. But other than that, thanks to everybody who had a trailer, everybody who announced, and I hope to see you next year. And I'm cooking up some other projects this year that I think are going to be super cool for the community. I'm super excited to share them with you all. I think there's, you know, so much I want to do with regards to the Celeste community. And first of all, I can't wait to get back to playing some more maps and, you know, leaving feedback on those, game in the comments and whatnot. So thank you. Have a nice night.